So I play a Eastern European guy called Victor Goria, who is seeking asylum in the UK, and he meets Daniel Lyons in a housing facility in the north of England, and they develop a relationship together, and kind of it all goes from there. The adventure starts, and yeah.
Can you talk about what is so very special about Russell's writing and why the themes of this particular project seem so timely and relevant today?
Yeah, well, I think what's amazing with Russell's writing is that it's kind of exploring these epic themes, but it's done in such a fragile way, and it's all about human contact, the show, and I think it can really relate to a lot of people because, you know, it's very cathartic and real, and it's about human emotion, and it's kind of all about how... you know, if the world's all going to shit, at least we can all be friends and we can all be kind of get through it together with love and kindness. And I think this show really, really explores that.
Talking about togetherness, obviously it's an astonishing lineup of talent in the cast alongside you. Can you talk about that experience and what it means to be sharing screen time with some of these wonderful people?
I can't really believe it. I'm so grateful. And I kind of, yeah, I'm just starting out my career and just finding out that I was kind of cast in a Russell T. Davies show alongside Rory Kinnear and Emma Thompson and Russell Tovey. It's been an absolute mad, mad show. So I feel very lucky, very fortunate.
It's rare to have a narrative that spans as long as the course of this drama does. Can you talk a little bit about the time skips and playing a character that evolves over literally about 15 years?
Yeah, that was hard. I'm not going to lie. But the good thing about that was you kind of could explore age and you could explore... It gave you a little bit of time, and obviously the makeup department on Years and Years really helped you with that, because you can't really... I mean, I'm 23 and I had to play a 37-year-old at the end of the show, and that's pretty weird. They put a little bit grey in my hair.
So we're here at the BFI celebrating television. What do you think as a medium TV gives both storytellers and an audience they perhaps don't get from other forms of entertainment?
I think it's something that people can... it enters a home. And I guess with cinema, you always go out to watch it, and it's more of an event. This is kind of infiltrates your home, and when you watch TV at home, it adds a different dynamic and a different perspective on the show. And I think it can be a little bit more emphatic and a little bit more powerful, because you're sat on your couch, you're having your tea, and you're watching all these crazy things happen, and you're like, wow,